back to where we're finishing this up. As you look at, there's a couple more I want to do, examples I want to do from this section. Okay. Let's look at one that has multiplication and division in it. Let's look at this one. 8W is equal to negative 75.2. Okay. Now the one in the book is positive 75.2, but I want to do a negative one so we can talk about that. So in this problem we're doing multiplication. So obviously the inverse of multiplication would be what? Division. Okay? And so when we're looking at the division, okay, when we're looking at the division, we have to look at, once again, which number are we multiplying by W?
8.
Okay? So the inverse of multiplying by 8 would be to divide by 8 to both sides. Okay, now, so these two cancel, leave me a W is equal to 75.2 divided by 8. Okay, now, it's okay to have whole numbers on the outside of your division bar or division bracket. Okay, you can have a whole number in the divisor, but you can't have decimals. If you have decimals, we have to move it like we did yesterday, but we'll get to that here in a second. This one's got a whole number. And so we have W is equal to 8 into 75.2. So 8 goes into 75 9 times, be 72, remainder 2, bring down the 2, bring up the decimal. Okay, 8 into 22 goes 2 times, be 16, remainder 6, add a 0, bring it down. Oh, thank you. Yes, it would. No, that'll help. So it is a remainder of 3. So we bring down the 2. Obviously, that goes to a 4. All right. So we got 32, remainder 0. So since it's negative, like I said, the one in the book is a positive one. But I wanted to do this one so it's negative. So we have the one negative sign. So that gives you W is equal to negative 9.4. So if it was this, like the one in the book, then everything is still the same. You do the same process, but W would equal positive 9.4. Okay, the process is still the same, though. Okay. Now, so let's look at one that has negatives and a decimal in your divisor. So we have this one here, 3.498 is equal to -0.53k. Okay? 3.498 equals -0.53k. Okay, so we're multiplying. This is where we have our multiplication going. So we've got to take and divide both sides by -0.53. Divide this side by -0.53. Over here, it cancels, leaving us with K is equal to -0.53 into 3.498. Okay, now we have an issue. Because we have a decimal here, I have to move that decimal once, twice to the right. What I do on the outside, I must do on the inside. So I must move this one once, twice. So that's negative 53 into 349.8 is equal to K. Okay. Well, 53 goes into 349. How many times? No, because 7 times 50 would be 350. So that would be too much. 6 times, yeah. So 6 times. 6 times 3 is 8. Carry my 1. 6 times 5 is 30 plus 1. 318. Subtract those two, you get what?
31.
Bring down the 8. Bring up the decimal. Well, now we know that that and that are the same, so it's going to be 6 there, 318, 0. So K is equal to negative 6.6. Okay, the reason it's negative is because there's one negative, one positive. All right, now let's look at one that has multiplication to solve. Negative 9.1 equals S over negative 7.12. Okay, so here we are dividing 7.12 into S. Okay, so to solve this, to solve, we must multiply both sides by negative 7.12. So if we multiply it here, over 1, and we do the same thing over here. Okay, over here it cancels, leaving me with S, and that gives me, I'm going to put an X there, it's just supposed to be that. That gives me 9.1 times 7.12. That would be 2170, be 8, carry my 1, 10, carry my 1, 64. 2, 9, 7, 4, 6. And there's 3 once, twice, 3 times. 64.792 is equal to S. And you have 2 negatives, so the answer is positive.
How do you know where to put the decimal? Huh? How do you know where to put the decimal? Oh, you can't do.
Could I have 1, 2, 3 places behind the decimal? And so we go once, twice, 3 times. Okay. So your homework, I have a lot of time left in class for you to work on it. You're doing 2.7. 12 through 22 even. And then 24 through 35 all. Okay, so 2.7, 12 through 22 even, and then 24 through 35 all. Okay, so go ahead and get started.